Guys, today we are going to discuss about the general features of radius. Radius is a lateral bone of the forearm and it is smaller than the ulna, and it is a bone which is a homologous to the tibia of the lower lip. As we know, radius is a long bone, so it is also consists of three parts. This one is the upper end, lower end and shaft of the bone. If we come to the upper end, the upper end consists of the head of the radius, and the head of the radius is a disc shape, or the disc shape in nature. And this one is the superior surface. The superior surface is concave in nature, and this superior surface of the radius articulate with the capitulum. It will attach with the capitulum and it form a radiohumeral joint, which is a part of the elbow joint. And this is the circumference of the head, articulate with the ulna bone. It articulate with the ulna bone and it form the radio ulnar joint, or the proximal radio ulnar joint, or the superior radio ulnar joint. And there is present of the ligament which are cover both of this bone, which is known as a annular ligament. If we come to the joint, this one is a, you come here, this one is a radial bone, this one is a radial bone, and this one is a ulna bone. The head of the radius is joined with the radial notch of the ulna. With the radial notch of the ulna, the circumference of the head of the radius articulate with the radial notch of the ulna, and it form a joint which is known as a proximal or the superior radio ulnar joint, and it is also a synovial pivot joint. And after the head, there is a constricted neck. This one is a constricted neck, and after the constricted neck, there is present of the tuberosity, which is known as a radial tuberosity. The radial tuberosity is toward the medial side, and this one is a medial side. All this one is a medial side. So you can see that this radial tuberosity toward the medial side, and it is also consist of two parts. One is a anterior and one is a posterior. The rough posterior part and the smooth is anterior part. So we have done about the upper end. In the upper end, it consists of the head, superior surface, which is concave in nature, and constricted neck. Then this one is a radial tuberosity, which is toward the medial, and it has two parts, anterior and the posterior part. Anterior part is a smooth in nature, and the posterior part is the rough in nature. So if we come to the lower end, the lower end consists of the five surfaces. It consists of the five surface. This one is known as a medial surface, and this one is known as a lateral surface, and all this is known as an anterior surface. The medial surface have the ulnar notch, and this ulnar notch articulate with the head of the ulna, and it form a joint which is known as the inferior radio ulnar joint or the distal radio ulnar joint. We should know that the head of the radius is present upward, while the head of the ulna is present downward. And there in the medial surface, there is a ulnar notch which articulate with the head of the ulna, and it form a joint which is known as a radio ulnar joint, inferiorly or the distally. And this one is a laterally, and this laterally, it forms, or there is present of the styloid process. The styloid, it is from the Greek word which is known as a pillar, and this is the anterior surface, or the anterior surface, which is the rough ridge like structure. And if we come to the posterior surface, you can say this one is formed the grooves. There is present of the four grooves in the posterior surface, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These four grooves are the basically on the posterior surface. And there's one tubercle, basically there is present of the one tubercle, and this tubercle is known as a dorsal tubercle of the Lister. And if we come to the inferior surface, so it is difficult here to discuss about the inferior surface. I draw a separate diagram of the inferior surface like here. this one is the inferior surface, this one, and this you can see this is a triangular like structure. This triangular like structure toward the medial side, this attach with the scaphoid bone. This attach with the scaphoid bone, and this lateral, which is a quadrangular like structure, this is present toward the lateral side, and this attach with the lunate bone, and these both form a wrist joint. Is a tubercle like structure. This tubercle like structure is known as the tubercle of the Lister. Tubercle of the Lister. And if you come toward the joint, this is a superior joint, which there is a radial notch of the ulna, which articulate with the radius and ulna superiorly, and there is a ulnar notch of the radius, mean that there is a present on the medial side, there is a ulnar notch. And when the head of the ulna, this one is the head of the ulna, articulate with the ulnar notch of the radius, then it forms the inferiorly or the distally radioulnar joint. And this joint is basically articulate or the joint with the help of the annular ligament. And this is joint with the help of the articular ligament. And now we will discuss about the border or the surfaces of the radius. There are three borders and the three surfaces of the radius. The anterior border. Anterior border is a border which starts from the radial tuberosity and it end at the later side of the styloid process. And this one is a sharp and most prominent border. This is the sharp and most prominent border, which is known as the medial border or also known as the introitus border. This is a border which have formed the introitus membrane, and it is a border which articulate and form and it joint with the ulna bone. And there's also border which is known as a posterior border. This one, if we show, this one is a posterior view, and this border is known as a posterior border. This one is a posterior border. And the anterior border, the upper end is in oblique in nature. The upper end is in oblique in nature, while the lower end, it is the vertical. You can say this one is all is vertical, and all this one is a oblique. You can say this one is the upper end. Here, from here to here, this one is the upper end, and the upper end, it is in a oblique in nature, and the while the lower end, it is in the vertical. And the posterior border, it also the similar to the anterior border. If we come to the posterior border, you can see this one also in oblique in nature. This one also is in oblique in nature. So this one is the posterior border. And if we come to the surfaces of the humerus, there is also present of the three surfaces. The surface which start from the anterior border, this one is the anterior border, and end at the introitus border, this is known as the anterior surface. And the border which start from the posterior border, this one is a posterior border, and end at the medial border or the introitus border, this is known as the posterior surface. And the remaining one surface is remaining, which is known as the lateral surface, which start from the posterior border to the anterior border, and this surface is known as a lateral surface. If we come to the side determination, in the side determination, every radius have the head. This one is a head, and this one is a constricted neck. This one is a constricted neck, and this one is a concave in nature, which is a surface, superior surface concave. This one, and this one is a radial tuberosity, which is toward the medial side, which is what is the medial radial tuberosity. It formed the three border. This one is the anterior border, this one is a medial border or the introitus border, which is because this border is toward the radial tuberosity, or the radial tuberosity toward the medial border. And inferiorly, there's present of the, this one is the medial side and this one is the lateral side, and the medial side is present of the ulnar notch. ulnar notch. Why this is known as the ulnar notch? Because the head of the ulna articulate here and it form the radio ulnar joint inferiorly or the distally, and there's laterally there's present of the styloid process, which is known as a styloid process. And posteriorly we come, the posteriorly there is a grooves like structure and the one prominent tubercle, which is known as the tubercle of the Lister. This is known as the tubercle of Lister. And the joint, this one is a upper joint, or the ears, the radial, the radius is joined with the ulna, and there is a radial notch of the ulna. The radius is joined with the radial notch of the ulna and it formed with the help of the annular ligament. These all joined with the help of the annular ligament and it formed the proximal, the superiorly radial ulnar joint. And this one we can, I have already said, this one is a interosseous border because it form and articulate with the ulna bone and it form a membrane like structure. This one is a interosseous membrane. This one all is a interosseous membrane. And inferiorly it also articulate with the ulna through the ulnar notch, and this is known as a radio ulnar joint inferiorly or the distally. So this triangular like structure, it is an inferior surface and this is articulate with the scaphoid, and this quadrangular like structure between the medial sign, this is known as a lateral, and these both articulate with the